ready for that August 21st quadricentennial Black Family Fun Day? Who ready for that Welcome Black America celebration, brothers and sisters? FDMG, baby. FDMG. Oh, victory is here, baby. Victory is here. What y'all gonna do? We got him. Garveyism, we got them. The weather about to break. Leo season is on its way. Get them donations in. We gonna shock the world. We done already shocked the world. They said we wouldn't get to school, brothers and sisters. Y'all remember that? They said we wouldn't get it. We got it. We got it. Y'all did it. No white money, all black folks. We did this. Heaven on earth, black power. And if we can do this, we can do more than this. This is just the beginning. We can't talk nationalism unless we nation building. We can't talk nationalism unless we nation building. We can't talk nationalism unless we are nation building. This is sacred ground. This is the Mecca of black consciousness. This is the ancient Kemet of Pan-Africanism. This is the Timbuktu of black power. Do you understand what I'm telling you? It's not a game. It's not a game. Send them resumes, FDMGresumes@gmail.com. It's not a game. Beautiful campus. Look at that, brothers and sisters. The whole block is ours. The whole block is ours. Talk to me. Talk to me. Talk to me. Look at those beautiful buildings. We got a big gym. I would take y'all into the gym right now, but we're going to do that a little bit later. We're going to do that a little bit later. Okay. Then we got over here, this is going to be the Pan-African Library. This is going to be the Pan-African Library right here where y'all can come and get y'all knowledge on, get y'all study on. Okay? Get y'all knowledge on, get y'all study on. That's what we're going to be doing right there. You feel me? You understand me? This is Ifatunde Avenue, Dr. Papa Boulevard. Ifatunde Avenue, Dr. Papa Boulevard. Where them black fists at? Where all my beautiful African sisters at? I can't wait to see all my beautiful queens down here on the Frederick Douglass Marcus Garvey campus. Looking all good, smelling all good, looking all beautiful. Butter almond, butter pecan. Don't forget that Team Pan-African Mid-Atlantic Movement. Maryland, where you at? D.C., where you at? Delaware, where you at? Connecticut, where you at? Pennsylvania, where you at? New Jersey, where you at? And of course, the whole world. Buffalo, New York. Buffalo, New York. Buffalo, New York. We will see you on Saturday, April the 6th, is it? And then Syracuse on Sunday, April the 7th. Saturday and Sunday, back to back, Buffalo and Syracuse, April 6th and 7th, or is that 7th and 8th? But it's that first Saturday and Sunday, Buffalo and Syracuse. Get your tickets, drumarjohnson.com. Cleveland, Ohio, Cleveland, Ohio, Cleveland, Ohio, Saturday, April the 27th, Cleveland, Ohio, Hartford, Connecticut, Malcolm X Day. Dr. Umar's coming to Hartford for the first time, Sunday, May 19th, Malcolm X Day, Hartford, Connecticut. Be in the building. Tickets at drumarjohnson.com. Somebody rolling up. Who rolling up on my school? Somebody just stopped in front of the school building, you know what I mean? Somebody just stopped in front of FDMG Academy. Let's see what's popping. Okay. I don't know. Black man driving a white woman. I don't know. What's this about? Black man driving a white woman. I don't know. Pulling up in front of my school. You know what I mean? In front of our school. So brothers and sisters, it's going down. King Kong consciousness. Okay. Thank you. I tried to let you in the video. I guess your phone ain't working. I tried to let you in the video. I guess the phone ain't working. You feel me? Orisha Oshun is the presiding deity of the FDMG Academy. That's the city of Wilmington right there. Okay, this is the quarry that leads out to the river. It's going to be beautiful, brothers.
Hey, Bakari, you did a request. Bakari, I never did this before, but I'm going to see if it works. I never did this before. Waiting for Bakari. Bakari taking too long to come on, so let me cancel Bakari out. All right. Who else got a question? I'm going to try to do this. Okay, here go Bakari. Let me see. View. Omar Sadiq. Let me see if I can do Omar Sadiq. Omar is unable to join. Omar, you played yourself, black man. Let me see who else we got. Michael Bay. Maybe I'm doing something wrong. Let me try Michael Bay. Add Michael Bay. Waiting for Michael Bay. Waiting for Michael L. Bay. Maybe I'm doing something wrong. Waiting for... Let me see who else is on here. Who else got a question for the prince? Okay, let me see who else. Dun Girls, from Nigeria. I see the Nigerian flag. Waiting for Dun Girls. Where's Dun Girls at? Dun Girls, is it me? Is it Dr. Am I messing up? God is the greatest, Kev. Let me see. Waiting for Kev 109. Okay. Kev declined. All right. View. Who else? Go live with Maurice Dunk, porn star. I can't go live with nobody called porn star. That ain't going to work. Ace Drummond. Maybe I'm doing something wrong. This is Ace Drummond. Okay, finally got somebody. Who is this? Is this brother Ace Drummond?
Yep, this is me. This is me.
All right, well, you're the first person I ever did an Instagram live with, my brother. So there we go. What's your question for Dr. Umar? I'm going to try to get as many in as I can before I head to my next meeting.
Yeah.
I'll go right ahead. Where you based at? Where are you at?
I'm in Ontario. I'm in Ontario, Canada.
Ontario, Canada. Okay, I got to get back to Canada. Been a couple years since Toronto, and it's been a couple years since Montreal. Go right ahead, black man. What's your question?
Well, first of all, I'm just honestly happy that you got your school. When I heard that you got it on one of your live Instagram feeds, I honestly couldn't believe it, and the price that you got it for. I'm just like, wow, this is actually happening.
You said the price that I got it for. What's the price I got it for, brother Ace?
I think you said 700,000, and it was supposed to be a million, something like that.
Yes, sir. We got it reduced. Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Correct.
But that amount. That is great stuff. My question for you, real quick. So I've been doing like a lot of just like researching. I know a lot of people like to talk about white Jesus this and white Jesus that, and that's the white man's God,
yes,
and everything.
Yes,
just recently, doing a bit of research, and just what it says in Revelations about the vision that they had of Jesus being, you know, having hair like wool and feet of burnished bronze and everything, and even just looking at how close Israel is to Africa. Do most of your followers know that, or probably have the sense that that Jesus was probably more likely a black person? And if so, do you think that it would be something worth teaching at your school?
The concept of the black Christ. And it's not a possibility that Jesus was black. it is a definitive fact that Jesus was black. Well, first of all, when you go back to ancient African culture, particularly along the Nile River Basin, you study that spiritual system, you cannot be considered a Christ, which was a title and not a name. You cannot be considered a Christ, which was a title and not a name, unless your skin was kissed of the sun. If your skin was not kissed of the sun, you could not be a Christ. So we already know, just by virtue of the title, that Jesus ben Joseph, Yeshua ben Yosef, had to have been an African, because blackness was considered the color of the divine. Blackness is divinity. Blackness is divinity. And so when you take that into account, then you clearly come to the realization that Jesus was African. We can go further than that. We can look at the fact that the tribe of Judah, from which Jesus hailed, was the bluest, blackest, purplish tribe of the 12 tribes of Israel. They had the reputation of being the blackest. We also know, according to the popular legend, that his family, his mother and his stepfather, Joseph, hid him in Kemet. They hid him in Egypt. Egypt, called Egypt by the Greeks, means lands of the land of the blacks. So if Jesus, as a child, was able to hide amongst Egyptian children, our Kemetic ancestors, he had to have been of the same hue. We also know from Dr. Yusuf ben Yochanan, our great master teacher and Egyptologist, that Jesus quite possibly attended the mystery schools of Kemet. He did not graduate, but he attended. Moses also attended the mystery schools of Kemet. That's where he got the Ten Commandments. The Ten Commandments were borrowed from the 42 admissions of purity that was taught in the mystery systems of Kemet. But let's go further than that. When you look at any of the coins, statues, or paintings of Jesus, all of them in the ancient world rendered him as an African. He didn't look like an Arab. He didn't look like Barack Obama. He didn't look like Cory Booker. He was a blue, black, purple, nappy-headed African, as have also been all other Christs. Every Christ in human history was an African. Buddha was black. The name Bood, B-O-O-D-H. Bood is an ancient word, that means black. In Ireland, the country in Europe where they had black kings, there was a black king called Bood, and Bood meant the black face leader, okay? Krishna means the black face, okay? They paint Krishna purple now. The East Indians, because of their racism, they paint Krishna purple. But Krishna isn't purple. Krishna is black. Osiris, Asuru, one of the Kemetic manifestations of the great supreme consciousness. Asuru was once called God of the perfect black. God of the perfect black. Blackness is divinity. And it bothers me to see so many Africans trying to do everything that they can to take themselves away from their blackness, when blackness is divinity. The blacker the berry, the sweeter the spiritual juice.
And the darker the flesh, the deeper the roots.
Absolutely. Absolutely. And in fact, for a long time, my brother, because of how ashamed white supremacy has made black women of their own hue and color and texture, for a long time, I had said that I would only marry a black woman. For a long time, Dr. Umar said that I would only marry a black woman. And it wasn't until recently, maybe the last year or two, that I came to the realization that I can't say that I would only marry an African woman, because that would be practicing light skin supremacy or black skin supremacy within my own community. So I had to catch myself and I had to check myself and say, wait a minute, what if your divine mate is light skin? What if your divine mate is butter almond, butter pecan, peanut butter, caramel, cinnamon? What if she's not kissed of the sun? What if she's not chocolate? So I had to catch myself, you know, because in saying that I'm only going to marry a dark-skinned woman, then I discriminate against all our sisters who are not chocolate. So I had to come to that realization.
Okay. Well, thanks for taking my request.
Thank you, black man. Stay in touch. Did you send your donation in yet to the FDMG Academy?
No, I haven't sent my donation in yet.
Okay, send it in, black man. And it's okay if it's a Toronto check or Toronto Money Order. We get them all the time. Shout out to the brothers and sisters throughout Canada who have been supporting the FDMG Academy. A lot of checks came from across the border. A lot of checks came from Canada. So we got to thank the brothers and sisters in Canada. And we'll be looking for your donation. And hopefully, black man, we'll be looking to see you at the Frederick Douglass Marcus Garvey Academy this August the 21st for the 400-year quadricentennial of the black resistance against white supremacy.
Thank you.
Take care, black man.
Have a good day, sir.
All right. You too now. All right, so that was my first Instagram Live. Who else got a question? I'm going to take a few more. Some of these names is off the chain. Let me see who we got. All right, I'm not waiting for nobody. You got to be ready. So if it say waiting for somebody, I'm going to have to cancel you on. Go live with the Prince of Pan-Africanism. You got to be level, Buatsum and Ivan Deverett. Let me see. Let me try this one. I am Deverett. Let's see who this is. Waiting for I am Deverett.
Dr.
All right.
Umar.
How we doing, black man? Peace and love, black man. How we doing today?
I'm good. How you feeling?
All is well, brother. I'm feeling marvelous. How are you?
Damn, I'm surprised I got through.
No problem. This is my first time doing this. This is my first time doing it, but I'll do it. No doubt. Where you based at, black man? Where you joining me from?
H-Town, Houston.
H-Town, Houston, shout out to Texas.
Hell yeah.
You know what I mean? Houston, Texas is one of Dr. Umar's largest support cities. Shrine of the Black Madonna, Martin Luther King Boulevard. I'm trying to decide, do I want to wait for Kwanzaa to do Houston or if I want to do Houston this Sunday? This summer. Do you think I should wait for Kwanzaa or should I try to make it pop off this summer?
Come through in the summertime. That's when it's hot.
Come through in the summer.
That's when it's hot.
All right, I'm going to come through in the summer. I'm going to contact the good queen, Naila, Queen Mother Naila, the Shrine of the Black Madonna. We're going to try to make the shrine pop off this summer. Go right ahead, black man. Sure, go right ahead.
So why they fucking with your school, man? Why people ain't fucking with your school like they doing? People like Diddy and Brian and all this bullshit. Like, you really...
Well.
And, you know...
Let me say this. And shout out to LeBron and Jay. The celebrities will get on board once we get it together. I need us to understand that. Mm-hmm. Black people are waiting for the celebrities to save us.
Mm-hmm.
They will not save us. They can't. They're too high on the economic horse.
Mm-hmm.
They will not lead the rebellion. No celebrity has ever led the rebellion, ever. Any people, any time, any period in history.
Okay.
Going to be held accountable. Until we get organized, we cannot expect celebrity support. And the reason we can't of all Africans, if that much, 1%. Jealous, a very envious, group of people. So they give the impression
okay, so Nah, it's just breaking up a little bit.
It's just breaking up. Let me Okay, let me see if they can hear me now. Can y'all?
Good.
Can y'all hear me now?
Yeah, I'm good.
Can y'all hear me now?
You good?
Okay, you can, but let me see if the people can. Hold on. Can the people hear me? No sound. Why is the people saying we don't hear one word that was said? You know what? Let me try something else.
Can the people hear me now?
I can hear you.
Okay, they can hear me now. Okay, they can hear me now. All right. So,
all right,
the reason I got the hate. Hold on. Let me answer that. Can you hear me, black man?
Go ahead.
Okay. The reason I got the hate is because when you look across the black conscious movement in the United States, when you look at the black conscious movement in the United States, there's no one else in my age group that are trying to build anything for African people.
Mm-hmm.
There's no one else. I don't care who you name. They're not doing nothing to institutionalize, to nationalize the black community. All they doing is hustling documentary after documentary. They're hustling debate after debate.
Mm-hmm.
They hustling ideology. They're making money, selling products, but nobody is institution building. So the reason they needed me to fail, the reason they needed me to...
So you, your last conversation with the last dude you was talking to, y'all were talking about.
Can you hear me?
Still here. He's probably breaking up a little bit. Yeah, you good? Can you hear me? Ah, fuck. I got you.
Okay.